Hello friends, welcome back to my channel. I hope that you're doing well. Welcome to another video and welcome back to another seasonal TBR. I am sitting down here to talk to you guys about the books that I want to read this summer. I will definitely say that I did one of these TBRs for spring. I can't say that I did very well. I think I read maybe one or two books on my TBR. Listen, I'm gonna keep making them and you guys will hopefully keep watching them, and if I read them, then great, but if not, don't judge me and I won't judge you, when we'll just be non-judgmental together. That sounds like a plan to me, I think. But yeah, I have 20 books to talk about that I would love to read this summer. I have some different vibes going on. I kind of have like three categories of books that I am kind of leaning towards in my summer reading, but cross my fingers, hopefully I can get to more of them this season than I did this last spring season. Let's hope, but without further ado, without any more jibber jabber, let's go ahead and get into this video. Okay, so I decided to start with my section that's probably the most outside of my comfort zone. I do read contemporaries every once in a while, but I just don't read a ton of them all the time. And some of these are definitely in some formats that I just don't tend to reach for. And then the other one is sci-fi, which I don't read a ton of. So I'm hoping to rectify that at least by one book this summer. So the first one that I have here is a manga. This is Orange by Achiko Takano. I think that I totally butchered that, but that is the first complete collection of this manga, and I believe this has to do with these high schoolers that get a letter from their past selves saying that one of the people in their friend group is going to die unless they do something to stop it. And I just heard really good things about this. I've had this on my TBR for quite some time, and I definitely really want to get around to reading this. I've heard such good things. I've heard it's really sweet, very cute, and I definitely want to read more manga. I don't read a ton of it at all, so it'd be nice to get around to this one. And it's just something that I'm really excited by. I used to read manga a lot more when I was in high school, and I just stopped reading it for no reason, like no pinpointed reason. I just haven't picked any up anytime recently. So really want to pick this up soon. Hopefully I enjoy it. Up next, we have a tear-jerking book that I am terrified by, not only because of the size, but also because everyone just says that if you read this, you're just gonna cry your little eyes out. And that is, of course, A Little Life by Hanya Yakuhara. I have heard such good things about this book, but I am terrified for all of the emotions that this book is going to hold, but I really want to read it. Every time I watch Emma talk about this book, and she just recently reread this book, Emma from Drinking by My Shelf, when she talks about it, I'm like, I need to read it, but I'm terrified. So really hoping to get around to this. I don't even really know the synopsis of this, but I just heard really good reviews and I'm in the mood to cry, I think. Up next, we have a Bachman book, and I feel like Bachman is on every single one of my end of the year goals, beginning of the year goals, seasonal TBRs, but this time I'm hoping to do it. And I would love to read Anxious People by Frederick Bachman. This one follows a bank robbery that goes wrong, and the robber ends up at an open house. And now all of these hostages are a part of his crazy scheme. And I've heard that it's really humorous, even though it's talking about some really hard topics, but I've heard really good things so far. Almost every one of Frederick Bachman's books I've heard great things about, so I'm really hoping to get around to this one like ASAP. All right, up next is the sci-fi that I was talking about, and this is actually one of my Owlcrate exclusive books that I'm really excited to get to, and that is The Ones We're Meant to Find by Joan He. I cannot wait to read this book. It just sounds like it's going to be so interesting and so fun. The cover of this book is absolutely stunning, and this screams summer to me. I don't know about you guys, but I love these summer vibes. And this follows two sisters. One is shipwrecked on an island with no memory of her past, only with the knowledge that she has a sister and she's trying her best to get back to her. And then the other sister, who is a very smart STEM scientist whiz, that is trying to keep the brink, their world off of the brink of destruction. And it just sounds like it's going to be a really wonderful story of two sisters trying to find their way back to each other. And it just sounds like it's going to be a really interesting sci-fi. It has like really mixed bag between contemporary and sci-fi, and I'm really interested by this. So really hoping to get to this one ASAP. I'm loving reading my Owlcrate books because a lot of them I haven't really enjoyed, so excited to get to another one of them. Okay, up next are fantasies and sequels. I have a ton of series that I would love to finish out like yesterday that I've been really lagging on, so that is what I'm hoping to do this summer, is just to work on some of my sequels, but also just to read some really awesome fantasies. As you can see right up top, I would love to get back to The Final Empire by Brandon Sanderson. As you can see here with all of my tabs and stuff, I made it about 100 pages in, and I was really enjoying it, but I was also in a big reading slump, and I wanted to read this when it had my full attention and I was fully invested in the story. So I decided to put it on hold, but I definitely want to get back to it. I was just really enjoying the story. The magic system is really interesting. This follows a story of a fantasy world that has lived the last thousand of years after like the Dark Lord one, and this is the story of them trying to take back their power. It has some really cool magic like allomancy, people that can ingest metals, and with those metals they can do different things. And you follow two Mistborns, which I've heard really good things about the series. I just really want to finish it off because I was really intrigued by it when I first picked it up. All right, up next we have Incendiary by Zorita Cordova. I really want to get to this one. I actually was gifted this from Mel, from Completely Melanie. I switched out the dust jacket because I love this cover so much more, but she did give me a copy of this, and I really want to get to this. I actually don't know what the synopsis of this book is, but the cover is just absolutely stunning, and it is intriguing me enough to want to pick it up, like, right now. So I'm really hoping to get to this ASAP. I think I've said ASAP in this video, like, 500 times. I'm gonna try to stop saying that. Up next, we have the last book in a series that I would really love to read, and that is A Vow So Bold and Deadly by Bridget Kemmerer. I have heard mixed things about the ending of this series. I loved the first book. Didn't love the second book, but I still really enjoyed it. And I'm hoping that the third book is really, really good. But again, like I said, I've heard mixed things. Some people have loved it, some people haven't. This follows, the first book at least follows a girl named Harper who is brought into this really crazy, intricate world. It's a Beauty and the Beast retelling where she is now tasked with breaking the curse on the prince. She also has cerebral palsy, so there's some wonderful representation of that in here. The characters in here are amazing. The side characters are great. I've loved this series so much, and I'm really hoping to finish it out. Hopefully, I enjoy it as much as I did the other two. Okay, again, continuing on with some series, I would love to read Siege and Storm by Leigh Wardigo. This is the second book in the Grishaverse. I have decided that I want to kind of work my way through the rest of the Grishaverse before I go back to Crooked Kingdom, so I would love to finish this out. This is the second book in the series. I'm not even going to go into what this is about. You guys have seen it, heard it, heard people talking about it, watched the TV show, I'm sure, so really excited to get back to book this world. I didn't love the first book, but I didn't hate it either. I kind of already know how it ends, so, you know, it's not like a huge draw for me, but I still want to see how we got there. So hopefully I enjoy the journey. Up next, we have another sequel, of course. This is A Kingdom of Flesh and Fire by Jennifer L. Armentrout. This is the second book in the From Blood and Ash series, or Blood and Ash series. I didn't love the first book. I think that too many people were comparing it to Sarah J. Maas, and it just didn't quite hit that top tier for me. But I still really want to continue on with the series. I was intrigued enough to own the rest of the books, so I do want to move forward with them. I have heard mixed things about the world building and the character development, which is something that I was really struggling with in the first book, and the amount of dialogue that's in these books. But I still want to see how these stories continue. I think that it has some potential to be really, really awesome, so hopefully I enjoy it more than the first book, at least. And the last sequel that I have on this list is The Serpent's Curse by Lisa Maxwell. This is the third book in the Last Magician series. I really loved book one in this series. It was one of my favorite books of last year. It was so freaking phenomenal. I did read book two, and I wasn't as blown away by book two as I wanted to be. It felt a little bit more like middle book syndrome to me with that book. Some people loved it. I just wasn't in that camp. But I'm really hoping that book three is amazing. I mean, this book is chunky as hell, so I'm really hoping that there is some meat to this book and not just a whole bunch of fluff. But we shall see. I also heard that this is not going to be the last book in the series. There is more to come. So that is exciting, but this chunky book is scaring me. But I really want to finish out the rest of the books that have been published so far. All right, up next we have romances. I have one, like, romantic suspense book on here, but when I think of summer, it screams romance to me, and so the rest of the books that we're going to talk about in this summer TBR are romances, so let's go ahead and get into it. Up first, we have a graphic novel, and that is The Prince and the Dressmaker by Jen Wang. I was sent this from a good friend of mine, Caitlin, and I really want to get to this. It's been on my TBR for a little, not my TBR, my wish list for a little while, and so when she sent it to me, I got really, really excited, and I wanted to read it for Pride Month, but I just don't think I'm going to be able to squeeze it in this month, so I definitely want to try to read it this summer. I have heard nothing but good things about this book, and I really want to get to it. It is LGBTQI+, it's a graphic novel. The art style in here is so cute and so pretty, and I just definitely want to give this one a go. Okay, the next three books I'm going to talk about are all Coho books. As you guys know, I love Colleen Hoover. I read It Ends With Us a little while back, and it's still, hands down, probably one of my favorite reads of this year. It was so, so phenomenally amazing, and I cannot wait to read more of her work. So I picked up three books that I want to read by her. The first one being Regretting You. I know very little about this book. It's a romance, but also a book about a mother and daughter relationship and their dynamic and how much their relationships affect who they are and the lives that they have. And it just sounds like it's going to be a really hard-hitting book, so I really want to give this one a go. And then we have Verity, of course, by Colleen Hoover. This is the romantic suspense that I was talking about. I've heard really fantastic things about this book. I've heard so many people say that it's so bingeable, it's unputdownable. Once you pick it up, you are just going to want to fly through it, and I want nothing more than that right now. So I cannot wait to give this one a go. And lastly, we have Ugly Love. I have heard really good things about this, and I think this was on my spring TBR. I really do want to read it, like, really bad. I am ready for some tears. I'm ready for Colleen Hoover to just break my heart and tear it in two, and I'm really excited for this. What seems to be a sad romance. Okay, up next are two books that were recently released that I need to read, like, ASAP. I said I wasn't gonna say that again, but I really need to read these ASAP because I loved these authors' previous works and I need to read them. The first one being People We Meet on Vacation by Emily Henry. This screams summer. I mean, vacations, beaches, people in swimsuits. Like, this is summer all encompassed, and I just need to read it. I loved Beach Read so much last year, and I cannot wait to read more of this author's work. I've heard nothing but good things so far about this book, and I really want to read it. This follows two friends that used to go on vacation every single year, and a couple years ago they had a falling out and they stopped going on vacations together. But Poppy wants to bring Alex back on one last vacation to try to mend the relationship and patch things up, and during this vacation they may spark a little bit of a romance, and it just sounds like it's going to be so sweet and so cute, and I'm so excited for it. And the last physical book that I'm going to talk about today is One Last Stop by Casey McQuiston. This is the author of Red, White, and Royal Blue. Again, another book that ended up in my favorites of last year, and I am so excited to read this. This is a female time traveling romance. Need I say more? I think not. I am so excited for this. I cannot wait to read it. It sounds like it's going to be absolutely freaking amazing, and I need it right this second. Okay, and then the last few books that I'm going to talk about today are actually books that were on my Kindle. I have a ton of Kindle romances on my iPad that I really need to get around to, and I just don't prioritize my Kindle books enough, and so that's definitely something that I want to try to focus on. So I'm going to give you guys four titles that I would love to get to. I'm really just gonna go off the covers because, to be honest, I don't really read the synopsis. I go off of what other people tell me that I should read in regards to smutty, dark, sexy romances, and that's what I do. So I'm going to show you guys four titles that are really pulling me in, that the covers are pulling me in, or the authors are pulling me in, that I want to read this summer. Okay, the first one that we have here is These Monstrous Ties, and this is by KV Rose, I think. The Kindle Unlimited thing is covering the author's name, but this is a mafia dark romance, and I've heard it's really amazing. It's so sexy and angsty and really, really good, so I definitely want to give that one a go. Up next, I definitely want to dive into some more Penelope Douglas, so I would really love to read Credence by Penelope Douglas. Again, I don't know what the synopsis of this is. I think that it is a romance that has to do with stepbrothers. I could be wrong about that. Do not quote me on that, but I heard that it has like an outdoor setting as well, so I've heard nothing but good things. I want to read it. Sign me up right now. Okay, the next one that I want to read is Damaged Goods by Talia Hibbert. I absolutely love Talia Hibbert's new work with the Brown Sisters, and so I'm trying to read a little bit of her backlist, and this is one that caught my eye. Again, I do not know what the synopsis of this book is, but the cover, the name of the author drew me right in, and I definitely want to give this one a go. And lastly, I would like to read Dare You to Hate Me. This is by B. Celeste. I believe this is a sports romance, maybe male-male? I could be wrong about that. Don't quote me. But the cover is just screaming at me. Yes, please read me in the summer because it looks amazing. I believe it's like a football romance. It's supposed to be dark and sexy, and that's all I needed. So thank you very much. Yes, ma'am. I'll take it. And if you guys would like to see a full TBR of all the books that I have on my Kindle, feel free to let me know. I would be more than happy to share that with you guys. But that is the end of this summer TBR. Those are the 20 books that I would hopefully like to try to prioritize this summer. I have so many great titles here. I have so many great titles in general. I just have way too many TBR books just in all encompassing. But I am really excited to hopefully get to a good majority of these. Let me know if you guys have read any of the books that I talked about here, and if there's any ones that you think need to go right up to the top of my priority list, you know that I will definitely take you up on that. But yeah, let me know down below what you guys think of these. Also, let me know if you guys are planning to prioritize any books this summer on your summer TBR, things that you're excited for. Feel free to let me know down in the comments below. But that is the end of this video. If you made it to the end, leave a leaf emoji. I don't know why a leaf emoji is the one that I thought of, but that's what we're going with. leave a leaf emoji down below if you made it to the end. I really hope that you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please make sure to give it a big old thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe before you leave. And of course, leave any comments, questions, and suggestions in the comment section below. And I will see you in the next video. Bye.